There's a man named Jesus going around the land. He's working
miracles.
Yes, he is.
Miracles.
There's a man named Jesus going around the land. He's working
miracles.
Yes, he is.
Miracles.
Jesus met a man full of evil spirits one day. Jesus said, "Let me pray while you're on your way."
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Father God, with love in our hearts and just lifting you up on this day.
We bless your name.
We thank you, Lord, for assembling us here, Lord God, and for just being in the presence here.
Yes, Lord.
We ask you, Father God, and we just praise you and thank you for bringing us from oldness to newness.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Father God, for this sanctuary. Thank you, Father God, for the provisions that you made for this ministry.
Yes, Lord.
Now, Father God, we just want to thank you for placing us in your life, Lord God, for loving us the way you do, for we being able to lift you up and just cry out to you whenever we need you, Lord God, because you said in your word that you would provide every need. You said, Lord God, that you would never leave us or forsake us, God, when we know that for ourselves.
Amen.
Father God, we ask that you, we thank you for your spirit being here.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, Lord, for the worship service that's getting ready to take place.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for everyone who came out to be a part of this.
Yes,
Father God, and as they leave this place tonight, Lord God, we ask that you be with them.
Yes.
Father God, to him now who is able to do all things that I can ask or imagine, to him be the glory.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Now, before Deacon Miller come up and give the scripture, can everybody just stand up for a few minutes?
Amen.
Amen. Now, do we all know each other here tonight? Well, let's take a few seconds to get to know who you sit by. Amen. Because while you get your praise on, you don't want that person to look at you any kind of way. Amen. Amen. Everybody feel pretty good now?
Amen.
All right. Now we're going to have some church. We're going to call Deacon Miller up to do the scripture. I just want everybody to stand while he does the scripture.
Amen.
Let God people say amen.
Amen.
Before I do the scripture, we might not have no money. We might be told from the floor, need a check up from the maker.
All right.
But God will provide.
Yes, He will. Yeah. Yes, He will.
He left on record. He never leave us nor forsake us.
Yes, right.
So God and Jesus, the only thing that's all the hope we got.
Amen.
I mean, the bank might not let you have something. He said He will do it.
Amen.
He don't run out, don't need no bailout. Our scripture this evening is coming from Psalms 34. Three verses. I mean, that good is going.
Amen.
You know, they say, once we get happy, just like a set of jumper cables on one and go from the other.
Amen.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
His praises shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad.
Yes.
Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt His name together.
Mm-hmm.
Let God people say amen.
Amen.
Amen. We want to thank Deacon Miller for that inspiring word. Now we're going to call the youngest member in Love Ministries to come up and do our welcome.
Amen.
Nene.
Amen.
Y'all give her a hand as she comes. This is her first time.
Amen.
So y'all show us some love.
Amen.
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 Well, you know, I got everybody's child, but this is my baby right here.
Amen.
You know how we claim it here.
Amen. Amen.
I rose to do the welcome. You're welcome to see, you're welcome to shout. Whenever the Lord lays down on your heart, again, I say the love.
Amen.
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 Amen. All right, now we've been having good old gospel time. Amen.
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 Start off with a good start.
It's all right.
Now, to get the program started, we're going to call. We have a comedian in the house tonight.
Amen.
And he is very good. He is wonderful. Trust me, he will have you laughing. Amen. And he's a man of God also. So we're going to ask Brother Willie to come up. This is our comedian. Y'all give him a hand, please.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Thanks, Sister Shep. Found in the book of Proverbs, a merry heart doeth good like a medicine.
That's right.
But a broken spirit drives the bone.
Amen.
It's God's will and pleasure that we prosper and be happy.
Amen.
Yeah, I don't know what the devil told us. The devil's been telling us a lot. But it's his will that we prosper and be happy.
Amen.
And be in hell.
That's right.
And he convinced me. I'm a serious type person, Jimmy. Don't too many people know I do come.
I've
been doing this for 15 years. When I get called out, I go out. But if it uplifts somebody, Mr. Peavy and I grew up together, and he asked me up in Pulaski. Said, Willie, you owe me one. Come help me out.
Yeah.
And I know he's doing great things over here in Love, man. Yeah. Share with y'all, keep up good work.
That's right.
God said, if you want to be great, be serving the all. Y'all serving people, that's where your greatness come from.
That's right.
Okay, we're not going to make you glad twice. We're going to get on out of here and get out of here. About 5 minutes. Before I do anything, Brother James Ray, raise your hand. That young man back there, that's my homeboy.
Yeah.
He surprised me. Came in here from Franklin, Jr. And say he loves about 5 years. Love that young man. He wasn't a guy I used to go swimming with. Okay? I got another guy that I grew up with. Saw him a couple of weeks ago. He don't know me from Adam Cat. And I can't figure how I know this guy so well. And he don't know me. He just like this other guy I knew. Grew up together. These two guys grew up together. One of them went out of town for college for 2 months. Came back home within 2 months. Got the big head just that quick. Talking to his buddy and said, hey, I'm going to use my name. Hey, Willie, spell rat. I said, man, you ain't got to go to no college to spell rat. I done been to the blackboard many times. R-A-T, rat.
No, Willie, that's not right.
R-A-T,
rat. Willie, you don't understand. I'm not talking about no mousy rat. I'm talking about the rat now.
So when y'all go out of town, don't get too cool. Don't get beside yourself. I promise you, this is a beautiful place. I didn't know all this was down here. When I stepped in here, I was just mesmerized by it. And those chandeliers, I'm just taken back by those chandeliers. Being a deacon for about 30 years, I've seen a whole lot. I'm sure other deacons have seen a lot too. You know, every church got one. Somebody said, man, I guess our church got two of them. A troublemaker. Every time you have a deacon meeting, you got somebody going to cut up. Deacon meeting was going on one night. The church was real dark, Brother Jimmy.
Yeah.
And they were needing lights for the church out. So this guy, real good deacon, he got up and made a motion. Brother Pastor, I want to make a motion. This other deacon said, I'm against making a motion. He said, wait a minute, brother. Deacon, let the man make a motion. So he made his motion. He said, Brother Pastor, I want to make a motion that we buy a chandelier for this church out.
Yeah.
The other deacon jumped up, I'm against buying a chandelier for the church out.
Yeah.
He said, Brother Bradley, why are you against buying a chandelier for the church out? I'm against it for three reasons. He said, why are you against it? The first reason, ain't nobody in here that know how to spend it. And if we had one, who gonna pay it? And my third reason, we need to take good money and buy some life for the dog church out. I got to get up out of here. 25th wedding anniversary. Patricia and I have been married for 38 years, so 25th. I can't remember what we did on 25th. But this one guy, he was sitting in church one night on his 25th anniversary, and he cried all the way through the service. And the priest at the end of the service, the priest said, man, I know you cried all the way through the service. Said, you really happy about your 25th anniversary? He said, well, I got two anniversaries. At least I would have had two anniversaries. He said, 25 years ago, my wife's daddy told me, so you either marry my daughter or you going to jail. He said, now, reading I'm doing all that crying, I would have been getting out today. Don't y'all let it get on me. Okay, tonight, the devil came into the church. So I said, the devil comes to church every night. Maybe so. But the devil really came into the church.
Jesus.
Devil coming to the church, run everybody out of the church. People run from the church, went off and left the car from Jesus. And so the next day, run everybody out, a little bit old man. This little old man, they saw him next day, said, man, we noticed something. We sat up in church, we don't run off because the devil was in there. We know it was the devil.
Yeah.
Why didn't you run? He said, man, I'm not scared of the devil. I've been married to the devil, Susan, for 41 years. last one. We got to get you some singing. I'm not going to make you glad twice. Last one. Pastor Mark, I've been homeless for about 5 years. I'm serious. I've been homeless for 5 years. I'm going to let it go tonight.
Let it go now.
I started doing it last week, but you know what? Alexander Wright, when they built the first airplane, there was an African-American guy that I heard he kidnapped to the Smith family. And they hired this guy, and I don't know who's been flying lately, but I'll tell you something, you will not see a whole lot of, you will not see many, you'll see some African-American students, but not many at all in the tower. In the air traffic control tower, you just will not see it. I'm gonna tell you, they don't see it. They got a code, and this code is, and you know what he done. So every time this African American go up there for a job, not for discrimination, because you know what he done. Okay? So what happened? They put my cousin, my great, 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 great uncle, up in the tower. And then just killed some hogs. And he's up there had some fat meat skin. Y'all know what that is. I do, I know y'all do. So he was eating skin. So this guy come in, this big DC-9, he said, Brother Tyler, I'm bringing my DC-9 in. What runway should I come in on? He looked at the muscle. Well, bring that thing in on the I-565. Then the 747 came up to him. Brother Traffic Controller, what should I do with this 747? Put that big baby down on I-5 South. The other guy said, wait a minute now. Did you tell him to come in on North, me to come in on South? He said, yeah. He said, what we supposed to do? Y'all be careful. Thank you so much.
Next we have on this is the Tabernacle Master Choir from Pulaski, Tennessee. Amen.
Tonight with five short songs. The first song we're going to do is Satisfied with Jesus. How many of you are satisfied with Jesus tonight? Amen. Only a fool can be satisfied with Him. The man that woke you up, the man that feeds you every day. Amen? All right, let's do this.
Satisfied with Jesus.
just call us anytime, amen. I want to know tonight how many of y'all are paid up, prayed up, and ready to be caught up. Because the Lord is going to be
caught up. Ready to be caught up.
To let the people have the last word. I tell you that I see to me victory. To let the people have the last word. I tell you that I see to me victory. To let the people have the last word. Thank you. bless you. How many of y'all know? How many of y'all know anything about redemption? How many of y'all know anything about redemption? Amen. Well, Brother Michael is getting ready to redeem himself. Amen. We're gonna do a song that everybody know. I want everybody to stand up on this song. I want everybody to stand up on this song.
See, there are times when you have to cry. And there are times when you wanna ask why. Don't you let go of this unchanging pain. Cause I guarantee my God will be there for time. Hold on.
Hold on, it'll be alright.
I guarantee that. Let me hear you say, hold on.
Hold on.
Hold on.
Hold on.
No matter what it may look like.
Hold on.
All you gotta do is hold on.
Hold on.
So hold on.
Hold on.
Through all your trials.
Hold on.
And every tribulation.
Hold on.
How many out there know that Jesus will fix it for you?
Yeah.
Yeah. All you got to do is call on His holy name.
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He told us in His word.
Uh-huh. Yes,
He'll fix it.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. I know. If I hold to I know the Lord will
Yes.
All right.
Glory. Mm. Hallelujah. Right.
Woo, y'all got to excuse me. I mean, y'all have it.
That's all right.
When people talk about you,
they come down.
They got made. I made it.
I made it.
Thank you.
Just what this. Oh, death, like a police, traveling through this old land. Sir, there's no justice. Every woman and man gonna need a lawyer. If I were you, that's the next thing I would do.
Oh, man, jump, and jump to the He went to Bali. Tell me it was a 3-day journey.
Oh, man.
Sometimes you have to sing about yourself.
That's all right.
Testimony.
Yeah.
All right.
That's
it's right. Gonna be just a little bit of it. Okay?
Standing right here. See, he's been good. Living on
Oh,
get under my feet. You ain't got no power here.
My God.
Amen. Let's give him another hand. Now we're going to hear from Pastor Baker and the Gospel Travelers.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
Good is coming.
Coming.
Amen. He said he will never leave you nor forsake you. So that lets me know at any time I need to be, he's right there.
Amen.
I can go tell him something that I can't go and tell my best friend. Because if I tell my best friend, I know she going to tell somebody. But if I tell the good man upstairs, just between me and him.
Yeah.
And that's the best friend you could ever have is the man upstairs. Amen. 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 Yep. Mm-hmm. Top of the room. Well. But I tell y'all what I have. I thank God for Love Ministries, because Love Ministries has really, really, really been blessed. Just when a lot of folks kind of Love Ministries out, they saw that when they found out that they couldn't do nothing to us, they tried everything in the book. But I tell you what God has for you is for you. Now, I can't get mad at you because you drive a better car than I do. That car that you drive was for you. Because I know eventually God got something better for me, too. I'm just going to sit back and wait on it. Because
right.
I know it's coming.
That's right.
Like I said, it might not be on my time, but it's coming.
Right.
I tell y'all what, let me get out this testimony. Me and my husband was coming over here on Thursday. And this is how the devil works. He knew we was trying to get this building set up ready for tonight. Now this happened on last night. I said, Lord have mercy. We got right here by Master Lake and Blue Spring Road at the light. My husband got ready to pull off in the truck, and all of a sudden it was a loud like the transmission motor fell out the truck. I said, now Lord. Now, Lord, you know, I tell you what, you don't know what God got in store for you until he give it to you. That's why I told my husband, God got something better for us. Amen?
Amen.
I might not be driving it tonight, but I know it's coming.
Amen.
I know it's on the way.
Amen.
And I'm going to go ahead and praise God in advance for it, because I know it's coming. I'm above happy. I prayed and I told the Lord to let this night of opening night be a wonderful, spiritual, and don't y'all know he did just that? He did just that. So a lot of times you pray when you think you're praying in vain. It's not in vain. Stay there. Stay there. He gonna answer your prayer. Stay there.
That's right.
He got something in store for you. Stay right there. Don't give up. Stay on your knees. I gotta calm myself down.
Let him use you tonight. You're doing just fine. Let him use.
Well, God is good, is he not? No matter what you need. Only somebody can give it to me is God. Amen? Because he said that I can have the desires of my heart. Is that not what the Bible said? Say, whatever I ask, it shall be given unto you. But now sometimes you gotta watch what you ask the Lord for. Because sometimes what you ask him for, it might not be what you're asking for. But I've known to God that he'll give you what you need.
All right.
not what you want. If God see you need something, he gonna give it to you. Amen.
Amen.
That's the kind of God I serve. An awesome God. An awesome God. He is so awesome. He's just awesome. Okay, honey, here you go. Y'all read me. All right, let's give the gospel travelers another hand.
Ooh.
We kept on talking. He said, Baker, I don't have a lot of luxuries in my home. A lot of people have today. He said, I don't have wall-to-wall carpet.
No, no, no.
Don't even have a concrete drive to park my old car. But he said, my father, he got a place for me. In this place, he said, the streets are paved with gold. He said, on a rock to stay.
on a solid rock.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Please, I'll be on. was talking to a man one day, he said, that was one thing that I done wrong. I stayed out in the wilderness a little bit long. He said, too many years. He said, so many years. I live in sin. But I thank God that one day he looked down and he said, and I'm glad that the Lord have no respect for person. But you'll find out if somebody have to do you a favor. Then they go all over town telling what they had to do for you. Yeah.
Some people feel like if they can get out there and on that house top. If you're out in the field, stay on out in the field. The Bible says he got a book.
That's the way you lie.
And he got names, our names in that book.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Especially in that book of life.
Yeah, book of life.
If you ain't careful.
Whosoever name was not found.
I found out. I can't whoop everybody.
All right. Right up.
All right. All right.
And I found out. It says that sticks and stones may break your bones. I learned not to let talk bother me.
Amen. Amen.
You know what I learned? I fell in love with God's blessings.
All right. Amen. All right.
Talk about me. I'm going to talk about you on my knees.
All right. Yeah.
I'm glad that my mother learned me. Son, you can't whoop everybody. And if you walk around with mad because son, whenever they talk about you, all you got to do is go down on your knees, tell the Lord about it. And every time I think about this son, I tell people sometimes they wonder when we sing God's got his eyes on you. But I stop by to let you know that all the good things you're doing, he's got his eyes on you. Can I get a witness? A lot of times people think because I say that I'm talking about the bad things. But I stop by to let you know good things is being recorded too. Can I get a witness?
Tell my God about me. You
complain about it. Because the Lord is looking.
He looking.
Makes no difference who you are.
He looking.
How much money you got in your pocket.
He looking.
He's still looking.
He's looking.
He's looking. And because the Lord is looking, can I tell y'all what we need to do? Can I tell y'all tonight? Oh, yes, sir. Tell them to be careful.
Be careful.
How you treat your neighbor.
Be careful.
Be careful.
Be careful.
How you treat your to be careful.
Be careful.
One of these old days.
Be careful.
You won't have to stand before the Lord.
Be careful.
I don't know right about tonight.
Be careful.
Everything you say.
Be careful.
Everything you do.
Be careful.
Say it's coming up again, Lord.
Be careful.
Oh, yes, sir. Tonight.
Be careful.
Oh, I say, oh,
be careful.
I made up my mind a long time ago.
Be careful.
Oh, yes, I am.
Be careful.
Every day of my life.
Be careful.
Oh, yes, I am.
Be careful.
I'm looking.
I'm looking
at Jesus. Oh, yes, I am.
Yeah.
A song that a songwriter wrote, and in every chance I get, you, baby, you. Everybody saw me when I fell, but nobody saw me when I got up.
Amen.
Everybody saw me when I fell, but nobody saw me when I got up. Nobody but Jesus. And I promise y'all, I'm gonna let y'all go, cause y'all been here a long time already. Amen. Everybody saw me when I fell. Oh, but nobody saw me when I got up. Everybody saw me when I fell. Oh, but nobody saw me when I got up. Everybody saw me when I fell. Oh, but nobody saw me when I got up. Nobody but Jesus. Can y'all help me sing this? Nobody but Jesus. It wasn't nobody but Jesus. Nobody but Jesus. Everybody saw me when I fell. Oh, but nobody saw me when I got up. Everybody saw me when I fell. Oh, but nobody saw me when I got up. Everybody saw me when I fell. Oh, but Talk. They'll call you everything but a child of God. Ain't that right, y'all? Hey, but tell them, I'm gonna let you in God's hands. Work every time, though. He said he'll make your enemy your footstool.
Nobody but
shoes all the way up to adults. And what we're gonna do with those shoes, we're gonna send them over to countries where they're having problems taking care of their families. And they're gonna learn how to prepare those shoes so they can have them in their household. So we will be having Friday Night Live on Friday. Next Friday we'll come again. We just ask if you want to just bring some shoes. Put them in a bag, and they have to be twos, not just one. Bring them in two. It's already been announced that we're doing a fundraiser for the gas giveaway. Those tickets are $1. If you want to buy tickets after service, you can do that as well.
I said, Lord, I'm new at this thing. I don't know what to do, but if you just take me, lead me, guide me the right way, I can do it. And I want to tell you, God did just that. I've only did this like, what, 3 times? And the first 2 times I was like this. But you know, when the Spirit come in and take over, that's another story. Amen. See, nobody knows what's your story behind your praise. Everybody has a story behind their praise. Mine might not be like yours, yours might not be like mine, but there's a story behind every praise. Amen. Well, Pastor Peavy, send your hands now. Jesus.
Let's give a big round of applause. To everybody that came out and made this trial run a big success, we appreciate you. We want to thank the Tabernacle from Tennessee. Give them a big round of applause. We also want to thank the Anointed Praise. Give them a big round of applause. Give my good friend Boogie, the Mona Lisa. And also, Deacon Willie Skip, the comedian for the night. Give him a big round of applause. It is our hope that something goes on here every week, whether it be throughout the day or whether it be on the weekends. And we want you to be a part of it. And we want to see your face in this place. Friday night, right here on Friday Night Live. Give Friday Night Live a big round of applause. Next week, we should have the things that we need to work out. All working, you know how when you go through a test run, you have some things to break down, like y'all. So, we're going to see about having everything taken care of next week. So, I'm going to ask you to give yourselves a big round of applause. Give me a look. I'm going to talk about it. Yeah, I'm not going to forget that one. she's in the house, yeah. I was saving the best for last. Yeah, that's right. I saw you back there with his wife, first lady. I knew it. Get Pastor Baker Mountain's first lady to be on. And listen, I have to say that I'm proud to see the head of the seven sisters here in the house. Amen. Sister Vivian, thank you. Queen for a day, that's what I'm talking about. And my lady is here, all the way from Madison. It's good to see you in the house. I'm waiting for the whole place. Yeah, I tell you, amen to be here. Amen, amen. And she's like a mama to me, so I want y'all to know I love her to death. Now, did you enjoy yourself? Ministry members, did you enjoy yourself? Yeah. Amen. And we have that love. And also, I would be amiss if I didn't think there would be constructors that made this possible here tonight. Sonny Fletcher. Praise the Lord, his holy daddy. He's in the house.
Yeah. He's security.
He's out there.
He's security.
No, he's security.
Yeah, he out there.
He's already done been promoted.
Yeah.
Already. So, we want to see you again. Come out and be a part of Friday Night Live. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Amen. And we're going to ask that you stand, and we're going to be dismissed. And maybe next time you come, we'll have food for you, you know, like little sardines. They only say, give him a big round of applause. Hey, Otis, tell them if they mess up, we got two security guards. We got Otis, and we also have Brother Bobby Lee. And tonight, y'all guys haven't saw people standing around in dog jacket and everything because they knew their security was in the house. All right. And to Deacon Roosevelt and his little wife. And also, we got them in the house. Also, we got First Lady in the house in the back right here. Yeah. Hey. The wife, Bishop Roger Aqua, yeah, she's in the house. And we thank God for you being here too. We certainly do. And all of you, OW, all of you that were in the house tonight, and y'all might have heard OW fussing on the radio this morning. She put it out there. Yeah, she did. And you were just saying what you felt. And that was good. And I appreciate you and I respect you for it. Jimmy, you got this on you got this. This is the first service in the new Live Sit on DLA. Give another big round of applause.
Yeah.
I believe in you. I don't believe in you now. And we're going to get ready to go. Let us now prepare to leave. And we want to leave on a prayer. Because you know something? Just because we see each other here tonight don't mean that we're going to see each other tomorrow.
That's right.
So therefore, while we have the opportunity of looking at each other, we ought to be able to just be filled with the name of this ministry, love. That's what it's all about. Let us pray. Father, we thank you here this evening for this program. We thank you, Lord, for the destiny that you are taking us, and we thank you for the things that you are doing in our lives. Yes. Now, Lord, somebody in here don't feel good tonight, but Lord, because the Holy Spirit intervened and came in, they feel all right now. Now, Lord, we ask that you touch right now any pain is within anyone in this building. Lord, somebody needs a blessing here right now. And Lord, we ask that you come right now and touch them, Lord, and touch them and make them feel whole again. Now, Lord, we also want to just thank you for coming in tonight and showing up
is showing out. And Lord, whenever the Spirit of the Lord moves within us, everything will be all right. Now, Lord, we're getting ready to leave this place right here. But Lord, we realize that one day we're going to leave this place and we're not coming back again. But Lord, we want to be with you. We want to be able to sit at your feet and be blessed. Thank you, Lord, in advance. Much obliged, Lord, for everything you've done for us. Lord, as we leave, hold us in thy hand. Now, may that grace, may that sweet Holy Communion, may it rest, may it rule, may it abide with us all henceforth now and forevermore. Let every heart say amen.
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 And amen.
Amen.
Consider yourself dismissed. Amen.